Good day, everyone. This is Lucas Jellema from the Netherlands. It's a fairly early morning over here. Not sure what time it is where you're listening. We're going to talk about modern times. We're going to talk about doing DevOps across technologies and across the worlds of various cloud services and on-premises. And we're going to be doing so using Oracle Management Cloud, a fairly new, well, it's not exactly new, but offering from Oracle Public Cloud. And let's start with a brief consideration of what IT really is all about. We're not doing DevOps for the sake of DevOps or Ops for the sake of Ops. We're doing it all for whatever the sake is of IT. So let's do a brief excursion. What's happening? What we see in the world around us is that application and infrastructure architectures are getting more and more complex. We see multiple tiers, we see many different technologies, we see the use of virtualization, we see architecture concepts like SOA and microservices. So things are getting more complex. And things are getting more hybrid as well. So we have a mix of technologies and vendors, and we also have a mix of locations, if you like. One cloud, multiple clouds, usually also on-premises, and on-premises perhaps even multiple data centers. So it's not just the applications that are complex, it's also the environment in which they live, the platform on which they run, which is complex. And we see a cry for agility from the business. There is a constant need for change of the systems, functionally, maybe also non-functionally, especially when it comes to security and availability considerations. And we see the rise of DevOps, where we say one team builds an application, runs the application, and fixes and evolves the application. So it's a single team that takes responsibility for developing the software, but also developing the platform and making sure that the software runs on the platform in the production environment. And we see what you could call big time and big data and real time. So through Internet of Things, social media, and of course the requirement to be available 24/7, we see much higher volumes of data and a much higher demand for the availability and the capacity as well and the scalability of our IT systems. So from an operational management perspective, we have a number of objectives. Most importantly, the value of IT lies in the business value it has. So only if the business value is actually delivered does IT deliver on its promise. So to keep the business value of the IT delivered as required and promised is probably the most important objective of operational management. So we need to know if and when something goes wrong and we no longer can deliver that business value at the required level. And ideally, we can even predict when something is going to go wrong and do something about it so we won't actually go wrong. And if it goes wrong at the end user, the business, the functional level, that's most important. And if some platform or infrastructure component is failing, that probably will lead to issues at the business level and a distortion of delivered business value. But maybe it doesn't, and then it doesn't really matter all that much. We want to be able to analyze problems that have occurred and problems that are looming, so we can fix them, prevent them from happening next time, or prevent them from happening at all. So we need to know what went wrong or may go wrong, where did it go wrong, when did it go wrong, why did it go wrong, who was involved, why did it go wrong, why again, what's the underlying cause. And we need to know this across the IT landscape, across all our own custom software, across all the standard software we may be using, across the platforms, and of course across the underlying infrastructure components in this hybrid, complex world. So some of the areas of operational interest, functional, is the business value as it should be? Is it available? Is security as it should be? Do we comply with the rules we've set at all the levels, the software level, the platform level, and the infrastructure level? And if we're not compliant, where are the violations? And are we using our infrastructure efficiently? I haven't mentioned cost so far, but of course, cost also is a factor. And if we can determine that we may not need as much infrastructure component as we currently have to still deliver the business value at the agreed level, then we can save money. Easy as that. So these are some of the objectives. It's not easy to pursue all these objectives. So we would like to have an operational management cloud, which is able to gather metrics across the IT landscape and bring them together in a single location so they can be analyzed and exposed and explored and visualized and reported upon and can be used to find problems, resolve problems, ideally predict problems, and perhaps use machine learning as an underlying technology to do so. And I mentioned metrics, it's the real-time metrics, and it's the log files that may not be real-time, but still provide a lot of information about what actually was going on in our systems. So the Oracle Management Cloud is such an operational management cloud. It gathers metrics at many different levels, as you can see on the left here. It brings them all together in a unified platform that's somewhere in the cloud, and it allows us to achieve our business objectives, or at least work on achieving those objectives, and it can do so for a number of perspectives. More on that in the next slide, and the slide after. OMC, you could say, really consists of two stages. One stage is to gather the hay, collect all the metrics and the logs, and the other stage is to find all the needles in the haystack, where the needles are the pending problems, the actually occur problems, and the underlying cause for those problems. Oracle Management Cloud, as you can see on this slide, it has several components, several dimensions that fit together, that work together, that have a common experience, and that also allow mutual navigation. It works across many different technologies, infrastructure platforms, and software platforms, across databases, across operating systems. Some examples are shown at the bottom of this slide. And it works across locations, across clouds, not just the Oracle Cloud, but also other cloud vendors, and of course, on-premises. And it will collect information from all these technologies and all these environments and bring them all together to a single location. And when the information has been gathered in that single location, we can do end-to-end analysis of process flows or any other chain of events, and where in all these systems and the technologies, certain steps in those chains and business processes have been performed, on which platform, which technology, it doesn't matter because all the information has been collected. Here's an example of one of the dashboards that Oracle Management Cloud Service makes available. The main dashboard and separate tabs for each of the dimensions that's supported by the Management Cloud. And I will be discussing those dimensions later on in this presentation. One of those dimensions is application performance monitoring. And that's where you could say it all starts. It's at the very highest level, where the end users are active, where the business value is most visible, and using the application performance monitoring section of Oracle Management Cloud, we can monitor in almost real time what the end users are doing and are experiencing. And for those of you who have seen Oracle Real User Insight, RUI, you will have a good feel for what this section of Oracle Management Cloud is capable of doing. It can compare the actually experienced response times for all the pages in your web applications with those times that have been specified beforehand. So when the predefined threshold is surpassed, application performance monitoring can raise alerts. It will detect sessions with errors. It will be able to send alerts to the ops staff. It can continuously check the health of all the application components that are exposed using synthetic tests. So even if there are no users, you can still check whether if there were users or there will be users in the near future, whether they will have a good experience. And it provides many capabilities to analyze the problematic situations. And I will give you a brief demo of that later on. So this is what application performance monitoring looks like. It has a dashboard, and on the dashboard, you can get an overview of where requests are coming in from, which applications, which underlying components are hit the most, and also which one have errors or slow responses. And this allows you to very quickly focus on areas where things may be going wrong and drill down to analyze those problems in detail, which I will be demonstrating. Here's an overview of selected sessions, in this case, the sessions for today between 9 and 9:03 a.m. And for each of those sessions, I can see the origin, I can see the device that's used, I can see the duration, and I can see the experience in terms of response times and errors that have been received by the end user. And I can drill down to find out more about each of these sessions. So, for example, drilling down for the first session provides insight and the overall session context, that's in the summary, and all of the actions that were taken by the user in the application. And this includes all the actions that resulted in communication from the web application with the backend server, but also all the steps that happen inside the browser itself. So APM works with an agent that's injected into the browser, as well as an agent that's running on the server. And the two work together to produce metrics that provide a more or less real-time insight in what's happening inside a session. And here's an example of an alert that has been set up. In this case, if the average page response time is longer than 4 seconds, then we've crossed the critical threshold and an email should be sent to me or one of my colleagues. That's what's happening here. And if that happens in real time, this is an example of the email that I've received. And it tells me, and that's important, for which URL or which section of the web application the exception occurred. And this allows me, by clicking on review details, to directly navigate from the email client into Oracle Management Cloud and immediately start working on this particular problem. It's also important to know that Oracle Management Cloud is aware of Oracle software, and not just Oracle software, but fortunately it has some advantages or some specific knowledge of Oracle software, like Fusion Middleware. That means, for example, that if you have a SOA composite in Oracle SOA Suite, which looks something like this, and if you're not familiar with SOA Suite, you can more or less ignore this, but just know that on the left side, we describe the service interface, and that's where requests will be coming in. And then the purple and blue rectangles describe certain steps in processing those requests. And on the far right, we see adapters and callouts to backend systems. So typically in the SOAS suite, a request is received, it's processed through a number of steps, and it will result in one or more calls to backend systems. Well, if we are using Oracle Management Cloud application performance monitoring to monitor an Oracle SOAS suite environment, this is the kind of output we may see in the cloud console. So here in the diagram, we see an overview of many requests aggregated together, and these requests were processed through the yellow-greenish circles correspond with the whitish rectangles on the far left and the far right in the SOA composite diagram. The orange circle corresponds with the blue rectangle, which is the people process, which by itself makes several callouts. And each of these callouts are shown here. The size of the circle either corresponds with the number of requests processed in this particular component, or, and that's our choice, to the average response time. So in this case, the big circles are the places where we burn the most time. So if we have to improve performance overall response time, the big circles are the place to look. The blue circles in this diagram indicate database interaction. And we can drill down on those to find out the exact SQL statement or PL/SQL call that was made to the database. So we start with the web activity that's taking place, and we can drill down all the way to what's the middleware doing to the database, and especially when we see that certain database calls take a lot of time, it's easy to find out what's going on. I've been told, that's not official yet, that will be announced at the end of next month or early October at Oracle Open World 2017, that we will be able to then, in the next release of Oracle Management Cloud, we will be able to even drill down further into the database activity and find out if, for example, we call out to PL/SQL, what's the internal call stack of PL/SQL and where is the time spent in all these calls. But that's not available right now. So another very important component in the Oracle Management Cloud is log analytics. And you are probably aware that log files are produced by virtually every component that's running in your IT landscape, whether it's the application, the platform component, the operating system, or the infrastructure itself. We have log files at many different levels. And from these log files, we can really get a lot of information business-wise about the application and maybe issues with the application, and also about the IT platform and the infrastructure. There's a challenge though. All these files have different formats, are in different locations, are not necessarily correlated with each other. To even get at those log files, we may need specific access privileges. And in this complex environment where we have systems running on-premise in the cloud and on various data centers and many different servers, it's exceedingly hard to get access to all the log files. And even if you have all the log files, analyzing them is harder still. Oracle Management Cloud Log Analytics provides a great solution for this. So it allows us to get access to the information from all the log files that are relevant, allows us to correlate across all those log files. If there's nothing better to do, then by time, but if there are other options like a session identifier or the ESID value with Oracle middleware and Oracle database, then it allows us to correlate across all the log files and to cluster together all the entries that belong together. It allows us to work with huge volumes. It allows us to easily find the outliers and also find the trends. So log analytics will collect, gather log entries across infrastructures, across platform components, and it will bring them all to a single location. It currently supports out of the box over 120 logging sources, different logging file formats that it can understand and parse. And you can add your own custom parsers as well. And this number is probably going to grow the number of out of the box logging sources that support it. After the logging sources have been parsed and collected in a sort of normalized format, they can be brought together, they can be compared, they can be searched, they can be aggregated, they can be visualized, and they can be inspected through machine learning. We can also define alerts on the real-time findings in the log files, and there's always a bit of a delay because log files aren't streamed in real-time to the Log Analytics Cloud. But on the information that is coming in, we can define alerts to search for specific entries in the log files that we know to indicate disaster or looming failure. There's the option to drill down from the applications application performance monitoring to log analytics to continue an investigation that starts with poor user experience all the way down to the log file entries that may provide an explanation for that poor performance. I will give you an example of that in a moment. This is what a log analytics looks like. On the right side is the actual content from the log files. On the left side, we determine which elements from those log files we want to see on the right side. And in the middle, we can specify how we want to visualize the those entries, if and how we want to aggregate. And at the top, we can specify a filter. And this filter can be by time, by content, by source, by log file type, and many other elements as well. So here's an example of a different visualization. And here you can see that we have log file entries across many different components, both at infrastructure level and at software and platform level. And you can see that we have about 1/3 entries from the Fusion Middleware WebLogic server logs. So that's a big contributor here. As I said before, various ways to work with all the details from all these log files. Filter, aggregate, visualize, drill down, correlate. We can extract the system topology, as you can see on the right side, the system topology from the system that we extract our log files from. So in this case, for example, based on the structure of the log files, we can see the various servers running either Tomcat database, just the compute node, so that's the operating system, or even our underlying storage, where we have received log files from. And there's support for some machine learning inside log analytics. Here, for example, we see the option to cluster messages. So instead of seeing each individual message, after clustering, we will only see each message pattern. And for example, the created connection pool message pattern occurs 32 times. When we drill down on it, we will see that it occurs with various values for the name of the connection pool. So by focusing through clustering on the message patterns, we can identify those patterns that occur frequently and that may be meaningful, and those patterns that don't occur very frequently. And it allows us to work with far less information than the entire bulk of log file entries. Let's do a demonstration in slides, but it was taken from the real live Oracle Management Cloud environment. Let's do a brief demonstration of how to use application performance monitoring and log analytics to identify a problem and its underlying cause. So here's my homepage, and I can see in the list of 28 pages that are sorted by the average load time that the worldnews.jsf page has a fairly long average load time, 9 seconds, which is way, way above the threshold. So let's take a closer look what's going on. And before I do so, I want to tell you about the underlying application architecture and platform infrastructure. In this case, we've got an ADF application, Java EE application, that's running on Oracle WebLogic. And that Oracle WebLogic environment is actually running in the Oracle Cloud. So on JCS, the Java Cloud Service, we've got a compute node. And inside that compute node, there is WebLogic, which contains the World Enterprise application, an ADF application. The application is interacting with a database, which is also running in the cloud, in the Oracle Database Cloud. Again, the database cloud contains a compute node. Inside a compute node, there is an Oracle database running, and it contains a number of data. Database objects that are used by the enterprise application that's running on Java Cloud Service. In this infrastructure environment, I've added a number of agents. Agents that collect the metrics and the logs and send those to Oracle Management Cloud. So in this case, on the database cloud, we've got the log analytics agent, which will collect the log files from the database, send them periodically to Oracle Management Cloud. On the Java cloud, we also have the log analytics agent as well as the application performance agent, which is injected into Oracle WebLogic. Note that this agent does not require any change in the application. It's injected into the WebLogic server by adding a few lines to the WebLogic startup scripts. And also, because APM has been injected into the Oracle WebLogic, the web applications that are rendered from WebLogic to the browsers also contain the browser agent. So the web application, when it's running in the browser, will also start sending metrics to Oracle Management Cloud. So in this specific case, Oracle Management Cloud receives metrics from three different tiers across two clouds and across potentially thousands of browsers, which could be anywhere in the world. Now I drill down to the slow pages. We're looking at the worldnews.jsf, and we see an overview throughout time of the number of hits on this page, which is actually quite small because it's not really a big application. It's a demo application. And we can see the average response time across time and also the number of errors that our users are running into across time. For this specific page, I can look at all the requests that have come in the selected time window. I can look at the individual instances. Here are the instances, and you can see, well, they're all from Europe. And you can see by the size of the orange bars that some really took long. Like, for example, the session that was started from Portugal, it has a page ready time for 9.63 seconds. That's the time the end user was waiting before he could start interacting with the page. And the indicator on the far left is yellow to indicate that this is really not good. It should have been red, probably for this particular experience. If we drill down on the session, we get an overview again of all the steps that the user took during this session. As I said before, this includes both the steps inside the browser as well as the steps that resulted in browser to server interaction. And I can look on the server side, that's not so much the user experience, but the overall overall metrics around this particular page. And drilling down still further in this diagram, I get an overview of all the steps that took place inside the server in order to service this particular page. So I can see in the yellow green circles all the activity that was actually running inside WebLogic. In orange is the activity that's performed by external services, and in blue is the activity performed in the database. And the specific orange circle, the biggest orange circle that I've selected, I can see that it involves a REST call using JAX RS, a REST call to a specific REST service, and on average, this call takes 4.42 seconds, and that's really not good. So we have to investigate even further. More metrics for this particular server request across all the instances of the server request. Here are, again, just like we saw in the diagram, all the interactions from this particular server request to external services. And I can even drill down further to get the call tree and even the call stack, the Java call stack for this particular callout. So the callout that takes place to the REST service that takes so very long. Here is the call stack, so I can see all the classes that were involved. And this may not be meaningful to me as an ops person, but as a DevOps person or a developer, this certainly is meaningful. So we now have found more or less where the problem is. It's with this call out to the REST service. And we have a specific ESET for the user session in which this problem occurred. Let's now go to log analytics for this particular session to get all the log entries that are correlated to this session and see whether it tells us anything meaningful. So we go to the related logs, we go to log analytics. It already has the right time filter set. Unfortunately, at the present, the ESET is not brought forward from application performance monitoring to log analytics. That will be added in a future release, but for the moment, we have to filter ourselves, which is not all that hard. We click on the left side on ESET to indicate that we want to filter on ESET. We then copy or paste in the ESET that we copied in application performance monitoring, click on apply filter, and now we only have the log file entries for this specific session. Now we filter even further on all the log file entries of level warning by clicking on warning, as you can see. And then I use the cluster option to cluster all the messages, all the log file entries that we have at level warning. This boils down to only three different formats. And here's the one that we were looking for. Built-in, intentional delay of 4 seconds when fetching BBC feed. No particular reason, just to see whether your detectives would find it. This actually is from a workshop that we've done internally with Oracle Management Cloud to have our DevOps staff use Management Cloud to identify problems. And by drilling down even further from the clustered messages to specific instances of those messages, we can find out that this particular log entry was produced from the class RSS feed parser with its fully qualified class name. This really should be enough for the developers to make the fix or to undo this Shelly approach. So the combination of application performance monitoring and log analytics allows us to find the problem as experienced by the end user, drill down, and hopefully find the underlying root cause. In this case, of course, it was easy, but it will certainly, in almost any case, give a lot of meaningful information, if not help to outright solve the problem. Oracle Management Cloud has other components that are worth discussing. There's infrastructure monitoring. Like application performance monitoring looks at the user experience at the business or functional level, infrastructure monitoring helps you to monitor the status of the IT infrastructure, which includes the database, the operating systems, and the underlying hardware, as well as the network and storage. So using metrics, real-time metrics, as well as the log files, we get information about the current state of our infrastructure, and we can identify any problems with that current state. Again, it's across various technologies, it's across on-premises and different cloud vendors. All the information is brought together to a single location that's somewhere in the Oracle Cloud, and we can do the exploration, the visualization, the analysis, the correlation, and more and more machine learning capabilities will be added to make recommendations or even perform automated actions. And of course, alerts are sent to the designated ops staff. IT analytics takes all the information that's gathered at more or less runtime that's used for operational purposes and makes all that information available for tactical analysis across the whole world, almost the whole world of your IT landscape. It contains many out-of-the-box reports and dashboards, and also widgets that can be reused to create your own custom reports. This section warrants presentation in its own right. I don't really have time to go into detail here. Then there's security monitoring and analytics, and it's similar to what we've seen before when it comes to system health and application performance. This is specifically targeted at, well, you can guess it, security. By gathering information on user activity across various systems, activity specific to security concerns, such as logins, access of confidential sensitive information, changing passwords, trying to access applications from different devices or unknown locations, all those events are gathered, are inside the metrics and the log file entries, and are specifically analyzed by security monitoring and analytics with knowledge of which patterns are suspicious, with the ability for us to identify the rules that we want to take action on, and Oracle Management Cloud will help us execute those rules, apply those rules. So here are some examples. The overall dashboard shows us the incidents, allows us to drill down on the incidents to see what's the situation, if action has already been taken, or if not, what action should be taken. It also shows a number of auto-remediated situations where Oracle Management Cloud was able to take actions by itself because of the rules and the actions that should be triggered by a violation of those rules in order to resolve the situation. And of course, we can drill down and find a lot of information. For example, here's an incident. And it's really the combination of events and a weight assigned to each event based on the rules we set up before that leads to a notification. And in this case, we've identified a real threat and an automatic action was taken. That's the final green box, so we don't need to do anything else. Then there's compliance, and it's related to security. It's not the same thing. Compliance can be on various levels, on business level, on IT level. And an example of a compliance rule could be that the patch level of all the Oracle databases should be the same, and the patch level should be on par with some value set somewhere, some value recommended by Oracle, for example. Compliance can also be directory names used should follow a certain standard. So there are many different aspects of compliance. Some are very granular, others are more high level, and all of them can be monitored by the compliance section of Oracle Management Cloud. So here are some examples. There's a compliance rule, there's a violation against the rule that all the database patches should be applied to all the database, all the databases, so there should not be a database instance which has a different patch level. And apparently there is one that doesn't have the right patch level. When that happens, we can fix the problem. It could be done automatically or manually, but still be automated. And one of the ways to automate it is using the orchestration facility in Oracle Management Cloud. And the orchestration is really Chrome on the cloud. It allows us to define jobs, define actions to be taken in order to correct compliance findings or in order to do any job really. All the agents that we've installed on all of our various infrastructure components, if we allow them to do so, can take instructions from the orchestration service and perform the action that has been scheduled in it. So here are some examples of the things that orchestration could do. And it's important that orchestration, through the information that's collected by Oracle Management Cloud, will know, for example, where to find all the nodes in the cluster. If a certain action needs to be performed against a certain platform component, and the platform component is clustered, orchestration will know where all the nodes are and will be able to perform the action against each of the individual nodes, for example. Again, don't have the time to go into detail. Some more insight into the orchestration architecture. The slides will be available after this webinar. The recording is available. For now, I will skip the details. Here's an example of a workflow that's performed by orchestration on behalf of security monitoring and analytics. So that's an example of we have identified a dangerous violation of our rules. It's a specific type of violation, so we know what the action should be to resolve the situation. In this case, it's blacklisting the IP address. So on the security side, we've said the IP address should be blacklisted. On the orchestration side, we have defined a workflow to actually go and do this. And that's what's shown on the slide. Oracle Management Cloud supports in a generic data exploring and visualization. There's a section where you can create dashboards, explore all the data that's available across all the services in Oracle Management Cloud that you are subscribed to. There's so much information, there's so much power in the analysis that it can be quite overwhelming. And there's a lot of power. I can't really tell you what all this power can get you because there's so much and it's actually quite complex. A number of out-of-the-box dashboards are available to at least show you the way. So let me tell you briefly about our first steps with Oracle Management Cloud, because they could also be your first steps with Oracle Management Cloud. Some of the points you have to think about. When and why. If you don't have a specific objective, then it's not much use to get started, is our finding. What do you need in order to get going? What are the practical steps to actually do this? And how did we get started? And what were some of the obstacles we ran into? Not too many, I can tell you. Why do anything with Oracle Management Cloud at all? And it seems like if you care about the real user experience, if you care about the usage of your applications, find out whether they are used at all, which elements and components and modules of the application are actually used. if it's important for you to make efficient use of your infrastructure resources, if it's available, if it's desirable to find out about incidents sooner, find out about the underlying cause, and ideally prevent them. And the more complex the application and IT landscape is, if that's your situation or one of these bullets describes your situation, then you may have good cause to try out Work Management Cloud. And if you go and do so, then define the scope of your first investigations with Work Management Cloud. You need an instance of the Management Cloud, obviously, a trial instance, or you could subscribe. You need some, but not too many, because I could do it as well, operating system skills, especially in order to install and configure the agent. It's not very hard, but it does require some, well, depends on the operating system, of course, skills on Windows or Linux or whatever your operating system is. You need, of course, to have applications and platform infrastructure components to do your test with. It doesn't make sense to try and test application performance monitoring if you don't have an application to performance monitor. That's more or less self-evident. And of course, you need a browser to access the Oracle Management Cloud. You don't need hardware, well, except for to run your applications and platform components, but those could be in the cloud. Oracle Management Cloud itself, of course, is also in the cloud. And as I said, you should have a plan based on the underlying objectives, because Oracle Management Cloud can do so many things. It doesn't necessarily guide you very well in your proof of concept or your first steps into what you should be doing. So you have to think about that yourself. The actual steps that you need to go through: you go to the Oracle Management environment, you create accounts for everyone who's involved, you deploy the agents, and then you configure those agents on the various application and platform and infrastructure components that they that should be monitored. You then need to put a load in the application and the platform, maybe intentionally cause some problems to see if they pop up and if so how, and then start to analyze issues you found to see whether it allows you to actually identify the problems and investigate the underlying resource. It might be useful to get some help, at least from someone who has been there, who has done it before. First steps always take time, and if there's someone to lead the way, it will be easier. Probably some of the slides in this presentation will already be of value in that respect. Well, here is what we did. That is exactly what I just said, that you should do as first steps. So let's not go into detail, we'll just show it on the slide. I started out with my own laptop. It was running SOA Suite and the database, and of course, WebLogic to run that SOA Suite on. I was using SOAP UI to make calls to the services running on the SOA Suite. I then added an APM agent, application performance monitoring agent, and it started sending information to our Oracle Management Cloud environment right away. It doesn't require any specific setup, except for, of course, a network connection in order to get to the cloud. By the way, if for some reason the connection is temporarily not available, then the metrics will be collected and queued and will be sent when the connection is restored. And I could see my first entries showing up in the Oracle Management Cloud almost immediately, which was very gratifying. A colleague of mine also had a laptop, which was running an ADF application, also on WebLogic. We installed the APM Java agent, same story as before. It started sending its information, and a dashboard was immediately extended with the additional information from the other laptop, the other environment, the other server. Then we also installed an agent for Node.js, and we ran a simple Node.js application. Same story again. Immediately, information was flowing from that agent to the Oracle Management Cloud, and in Management Cloud, we could immediately see the application performance monitoring metrics collected from the Node application. Our subsequent steps, we went to a customer. That's the final bullet on this slide. We went to a customer, and this customer was having tremendous problems, and to be honest, is still having tremendous problems with especially the scalability, but also the ability to identify the cause of problems in the landscape. The simplified version of the landscape looks, it's on the next slide. It's a complex environment, it's multi-tier, it's multi-node, it's across a great number of servers and locations. It's not yet in the cloud. It uses Fusion middleware, many different components, and the Oracle database. And they have issues with the performance, long response times. They have issues with the number of errors and exceptions. Some seem to be caused at the platform level. Some seem to be caused inside the application, but it's very hard for them to analyze. And they see a slow degradation over time, leading to a server reboot as the not so elegant temporary workaround. They find it very hard to monitor and to identify the exact location and cause of the problems. So this is what their landscape looks like logically. It doesn't show all the individual servers and nodes and components. This is to give you a rough understanding. It also shows in the green line some of the flows through this landscape. And you can see how it might be difficult to track down issues with user performance if these requests are handled by so many components. Where's the problem? And how are the components impacting each other? We have a number of research questions. Which application components are used at all? When? At what times? What are the peak loads? What's the non-functional user experience? Which users are having problems and they may not always call up the service desk to complain? And of course, we don't want them to have to call in order to let us know that they have problems. And we want to have insight into the bottlenecks in the multi-tier architecture and the infrastructure. Where are the hotspots that are letting us down? And we want to have the root cause analysis, the ability to drill down from the application experience level all the way down to infrastructure if we have to. So what we did for this particular client, and that's before they spent any money, well, only on us, but not on any software, any hardware, etc. Trial access to OMC, configure the agents on a number of servers just for a proof of concept, just to get started. And this is more or less what the pilot looked like. So we have a number of agents in the red ellipses, and they all send information, either performance metrics or the log files, to Oracle Management Cloud. Before, we didn't have an end-to-end overview at all. This picture, this slide, probably is the best kind of end-to-end overview that we have. In a very short matter of time, we were able to start producing, based on the metrics collected by the agents and by setting the right log levels in the applications and on the platform components, we were able to very quickly start exploring the findings and to analyze the logging. And we didn't pursue this for a long period, but we were able to demonstrate very quickly, to prove very, very quickly what the capabilities are. And here are some of the screenshots from this pilot. And obviously, I'm not able to go into detail, not even allowed to go into detail. But in a few hours, we were able to start providing the first insight that we had not been able to get otherwise. What we didn't do in this pilot, it's important to realize what we didn't do. We didn't arrange any hardware, which is a good thing, but because it would have taken weeks. We didn't acquire and install any software. Again, would have taken a long time. We didn't have to configure the network, because Well, the connection between the components is already there, and the only thing we had to do was add an agent that only made callouts to outside the network, to the internet, which is already allowed. No incoming calls are required for Argo Management Cloud. We didn't have to arrange for any access privileges to get to log files. The agents are installed by the administrators for this specific platforms. That's all that was required. We didn't have to hire expensive, hard to find experts to get going because it's so easy to get going. The skills required to make these first steps aren't very specific. So we didn't have to wait for a long time ago through a difficult process, procedure in this customer's organization in order to make the decision to even get started. We got started and we were almost done the same day. The pilot was up and running in an afternoon, and then we spent two more days collecting additional information, running a representative load on the application and the platform. Probably was the hardest part of it, not setting up Oracle Management Cloud. So some of the things that APM and Log Analytics provide this particular customer, information about what we can learn about what the users are doing, what the users are experiencing. Of course, we need to enrich application level logging. That's an insight for the developers who need to take responsibility for ops as well. That if they provide better logging from their application code, doing operations, investigating problems that occur becomes much more easy. And we are sure it will make developers produce better logging from their code. Note that we want to use Oracle Management Cloud not just for runtime production systems, but also in our development environment, because we found that by having the developers use Management Cloud during their development work and their early testing work, provides them with enormous insight into their own application architecture, into their own code, into the value or non-value of the logging they provide, of the metrics they put out, and also investigating issues is much faster for developers using the Management Cloud than using traditional tools. So it's not even just for the production situation, it's not just for administrators or the typical ops staff, it's really for developers as well. And since we want developers to be DevOps people, this is a very good first step. And to my surprise, I found out about a number of tool features, framework features, and Oracle database components that I didn't know about before, from the information gathered for me by Oracle Management Cloud. For example, database package DBMS Pickle. It's not one you probably want to start using right away. I'd never heard about it. Now I know how it's used and what it's for. Some learning points. It's very simple to get going with Oracle Management Cloud. It's maybe deceptively simple. Because once you start gathering metrics and log files, it may not always be simple to determine what to do with all that information. And very quickly, you can be overwhelmed, you can drown in your haystack, and you will find the needles only by accident, even if it's a very big needle. So think about what you want to do, think about which information is meaningful, and think about how to leverage that information to get what you want. And only then start expanding the scope of your Oracle Management Cloud setup. It's simple, but if you don't think, then quickly you will be overwhelmed and you may throw it aside. Configuring the agents can be very simple, can be very smooth and straightforward, but sometimes it's not. There are still some small errors in some of the documentation or some of the configuration files, so you will have to keep thinking yourself where to put files and what to put inside the files, the configuration files for the agents. APM is great. However, it's very focused on the user interface. It would be nice if it also supported API access, especially since we will be seeing much more rich web client applications with a JavaScript single page application that makes many API calls. So the user experience is determined to a large part by those API calls. At the moment, APM doesn't really support business indicators. It would allow us to label sessions, to group sessions, and be able to aggregate or filter information, for example, for all the users of a specific site in our organization or all the users in a specific role in our organization. And the map, and that's not very important, the map on which the requests are visualized is not very granular. Right now, I can see requests are coming from the Netherlands, but not from any province or any city within the Netherlands. And we are small, but not that small, so I'd like to have a little bit more granularity. With log analytics, if you don't set the right logging levels and thresholds in your application components and in your platform components, then you won't have any meaningful logging or too much of it, especially you may not have any logging. So that's something that you need to take care of. And you need to take care of the applications to produce meaningful logging. And it's something for your own developers, it may be something for your standard application providers. The deep link between APM and log analytics is great, but it could be better. For example, it should bring the ESET along from APM to log analytics and immediately filter on that ESET. It's not a big deal, and I'm sure it will be dealt with. Log Management Cloud is still evolving very rapidly. Oracle has many, many, many resources dedicated to developing Oracle Management Cloud. It's one of the strategic products within the Oracle Public Cloud, so that's a good thing. Not every feature that you would expect is available today. It's still very much evolving, so it's not stable, it's not completely mature. It can be used, it's very valuable, but it still will get more and more functionality and features as time passes. So, in brief, my conclusion. I think this is a compelling story. Oracle Management Cloud is one of my favorite Oracle Cloud services. It's intuitive, it has a very clear business value, you know what it's for, it's easy to get started with, it works across technology stacks, it works across various on-premises locations and across various clouds. It really supports operational management from one single cloud solution. It supports operational management at various levels. The functional business level, the platform and infrastructure level, the development environment and the production and runtime environment. It brings together everyone with an interest or a responsibility or both for the ops side of our application world, of our IT landscape. And at ops time is where we create the real business value. So it's essential. Like I said, it facilitates the end-to-end development. And it's a great first cloud to embrace. Oracle Management Cloud doesn't take any business data. You're not bringing anything off-site that's really sensitive. It doesn't require any specific configuration. I think it's very easy to get started with, if only on a very small scale for one or two applications, one or two infrastructure components. You can't go wrong with Oracle Management Cloud. So I hope this has given you some idea of how Oracle Management Cloud can be used for DevOps and for many things that you may not label DevOps but are still extremely useful. And I hope that I've created some idea in your heads to give it a try. With that, I wish you all a good evening and until some other time. Bye for now. Thank you.